this house. It's a Queen Anne Victorian, built in 1890. It's a 2,900 square foot, move-in ready. It's listed at 212.
This is not crazy busy. There's certainly some traffic, and it's a little loud, but we'll see how that is inside.
Oh, wow. This is really pretty. I love all of the details. Look at those stained glass windows.
He's got this great mural post.
It seems like a solid entrance.
Just off the main entrance is the living room.
Seriously, nice size. Huge windows, and I love the view of the river.
How
are
you ever lay things out
here? We have a nice wide doorway. It's kind of small. We need to fit 10, 12 people, and this would be a great time. They see a half bath off the dining room, then move on to the kitchen. It's been updated, but it's not 1890. This used to be the original garage.
Oh, you're kidding. What are these floors?
I've never seen anything like it.
Holy smokes.
And it's sort of a weird location. Like, what would we even use this room for? It's a nice deck. Would be great for entertaining. Not a whole lot of usable space, however.
Lovely detail here. How this just kind of hangs out here and cantilevers on the stage. This is great.
Here's the first bedroom. The front of the house. It's kind of small. And
where would we put a bathroom? And I guess maybe if there's some room on the other side, we could blow through and do some things there.
Some new carpeting in it.
Yeah.
I love that. How historic is beige carpet?
It's comfort.
It's comfort, but there are other ways to do that.
This isn't all about what Julie wants. This is a joint effort that we're working on, not just a dictatorship.
I see another bathroom and bedroom on their way to the master.
Bathroom here. It is set up as a Jack and Jill. Over here is the dressing room, but you could make a fifth bedroom since it accesses the hallway.
If this was a bedroom, we'd have to share the bathroom, which we're not going to do.